Hello everyone and welcome to Study IQ English. I'm Joycey Joy. In this video, we will discuss about Indian financial market. We are getting started with a new chapter, Chapter 11, Indian Financial Market from Ramesh Singh for Indian Economy. And today we will discuss about Indian money market in general, what is the need for money market and what are the various instruments used in Indian money market. So let's get started, starting with the introduction. Now first we will see what is a financial market. The definition of financial market: the market of an economy where funds are transacted between the fund surplus and fund scarce individuals and groups is called the financial market. So this is the definition for a financial market. By definition, a financial market means a market in an economy where funds are transacted from surplus to deficit. That is, whoever has a surplus of funds, those individuals who have a surplus of funds, transact these funds to fund scarce individuals or groups. That is, those who have surplus funds invest in those companies or capital of entities where there is a shortage or scarce. Now, the one who has a surplus funds is called the investor, and the one who has the scarce of resources or scarce of funds is called the issuer of financial instruments or money market or financial market instruments. Now, the basis of transaction is either interest or dividend. That is, those who have excess of capital, that is, those who have surplus of funds, is called the investor. Now, an investor invests the money based on interest or dividend. That is, the return that the investor gets is called either the interest or the dividend. That is the return. So the return that an investor gets, is either the interest or the dividend. So it can be an interest yielding instrument or a dividend earning. What is interest? Interest is a periodic payment of returns. What is dividend? Dividend is the part of profit of a company. That is, the share of profit of a company is called the dividend. So either the investor gets the interest, that is periodical payment of returns, or dividend, which is the part or the share of profit of a company. This market might have its organized as well as non-organized segments in an economy. So, financial market can be either organized or unorganized, which means that the financial market can operate through regulators or outside the purview of the regulators. The regulator of the financial market is SEBI. SEBI is Securities and Exchange Board of India. So, financial market can operate within the purview of the regulator or outside the purview of the regulator. Financial markets in every economy are having two separate segments today. One is to cater the needs of or the requirements of short-term funds, and the other is to cater the needs of long-term funds. That is, there are two segments in a financial market. One segment is which deals with short-term funds. Another segment is which deals with long-term funds. And that segment of financial market which deals with short-term funds are known as money market. And that segment which deals with long-term funds are called capital market. So, the segment of financial market that deals with short-term funds are known as money market. And the segment of financial market which deals with long-term funds are called as capital market. The short-term financial market is called the money market, while the long-term financial market is called the capital market. Now, this is the difference between a money market and the capital market. So, money market is a kind of financial market that deals with short-term funds. And what is meant by a short-term fund? A short-term fund means that those financial instruments which has a maturity of less than 1 year. That is, short-term instruments. That is, maturity period of the financial instrument is less than 1 year. Now, capital market, the market which deals with long-term fund. So, what is long-term fund? Those financial instruments who has a maturity period of more than 1 year is called a long-term fund. Maturity period is more than 1 year. The money market fulfills the requirements of funds for a period up to 364 days. That is what we said. Maturity period is less than 1 year. 1 year is 365 days. So money market instruments has a maturity of maximum 364 days. So money market fulfills the requirements of funds for a period of up to 364 days, while the capital market does the same for the period above 364 days. So capital market instruments, financial instruments under the capital market has a maturity period of more than 364 days. Now coming to Indian money market. So let's see from the Indian context, what is a money market? They are short-term market, which means that they deal with financial instruments having short-term, having a maturity of less than 1 year. Less than 1 year. That's why it's called a short-term market. Second is money is core aspect here. So money is the core aspect here. The market operates both organized and unorganized channels. So it operates in both organized and unorganized channel. Now, how do we classify organized and unorganized separately? Which means organized means within the regulator's purview. That is regulated markets. Organized means regulated. Regulated by regulators. Now, unorganized means unregulated market. They are not regulated. That is regulated and unregulated, or organized and unorganized. So in India, the money market operates in both organized sector as well as in unorganized sector. It is traded between individuals or financial institutions, banks and government. So money market here, individuals, financial institutions, banks, the government. These are different stakeholders. These are the different stakeholders. So it is traded between individuals or financial institutions, banks or the government. The exchange is done on a rate known as the discount rate. So exchange is done on a rate called discount rate. So discount rate is important. So what is a discount rate? It is a rate at which the exchange is done in a money market. It is the rate at which exchange is done in a money market. Now the discount rate depends upon availability of funds. Now suppose there is a surplus of funds available, then the discount rate would be less. And when there is less funds available, discount rates would be high. So it depends on the availability of funds. Discount rate also changes. Borrowings may be or may not be collateral free. That is, the borrowings may be secured or unsecured. So there are two types of borrowings in money market. One is secured borrowings, another one is unsecured borrowings. Secured borrowings are those borrowings for which there is a collateral, a guarantee in the form of a collateral. And unsecured borrowings are those borrowings which are not guaranteed by a collateral. So borrowings can be two types. One is secured or unsecured. So secured or unsecured borrowings. Now secured borrowings are those borrowings which are secured by a collateral or guaranteed by a collateral. And unsecured are those borrowings which are not guaranteed by a collateral. Financial assets having quick conversion quality into money and carry minimal transaction costs are also traded here. Those financial instruments which are having a quick conversion quality, we call it as liquidity. What is liquidity? Liquidity is the ease with which you can convert a financial instrument into money or equivalent to money. So we call it as liquidity. Financial assets having quick conversion quality, which means liquid assets. So those financial instruments which has a quick conversion quality is called as liquid assets. Having quick conversion quality into money and carry minimal transaction costs are also traded in a money market. Hence the liquidity aspect is very high here. So why is liquidity aspect very high in money market? This is because those financial instruments which are traded in a money market are highly liquid, which means which can be easily converted into cash or cash equivalent. Those financial instruments traded in a money market can be easily converted into cash or cash equivalent. This can work in both organized and unorganized way. So this can work in both organized and unorganized way, which means that Again, the instruments used in financial market, that is the money market, the first classification of financial market, money market, the instruments traded here can be through organized channels or through unorganized channels. Now, let's understand what is the significance of money market or why there is a need for money market. As we said, money market is the market which deals with short-term financial instruments which have a maturity period of less than 1 year. So why do we need such kind of financial instruments with a shorter maturity period, or why do we need a money market? First is easy availability of money. Because the money is required only for a short period of time, it's very easy to get money or raise capital under money market. Now when we compare it with the capital market, in case of capital market, the fund is required for a long term. So the procedure or the complications would also be high. It's not very easy to raise capital for a very long term. So compared to capital market, it's very easy to raise money or raise capital in a money market. So first feature is that easy availability of money. Second is that it supports income generation. Third, it supports growth. How does it support growth? Because this will enable investments and thereby GDP can increase. GDP can increase. Supports day-to-day shortfalls of working capital. Why day-to-day shortfalls of working capital? Because under a money market, funds are available for short term. There are instruments, financial instruments, even with a maturity period of 1 day also. So money can be transacted even for 1 day and up to 364 days. Maturity period in a money market ranges from 1 day to 364 days. So funds can be raised, capital can be raised for meeting the day-to-day expenditure or the working capital requirements. It supports capitalistic goals. How? By supporting investment. Now, scarcity of funds during lockdown or non-availability can push a system into distress. So, easy availability of money and especially for short tenure can be made through money market. Now, coming to money market in India. The organized form of money market in India is just close to 3 decades old, which means that money market, the organized money market in India is very young. It is only about 30 years old. The money market became very popular and it became a part of the formal sector only about 30 years ago. One more thing to be added here is that 1991 reforms, the LPG reforms or the new economic policy NEP of 1991 had a very significant role here. That is, the money market became more popular and more formal after the 1991 reforms. And that's why we say that it's only about 30 years old in India. So organized form of money market. Before that, there existed unorganized forms of money market. But the organized forms of money market in India is just about 30 years old. And it became more popular after the 1991 reforms. Its presence has been there but restricted to government only. Before that, there was a presence of money market, but it was restricted to public sector or it was restricted to the government sector. The Chakravarti Committee, which was set up in 1985, was the committee for the very first time underlined the need for an organized money market in the country, and Vagul Committee 1987 laid the blueprint for a development. So these are the two committees that you should remember in connection with the history of money market in India. First is Chakravarti Committee, second one is Vagul Committee. So in 1985, the committee headed by Chakravarti Committee was set up, and this was the very first committee that underlined the need for an organized money market. So this was a committee that suggested that there is a need for an organized money market in India. Now again, why is Vagul Committee important? Vagul Committee is important because it laid the blueprint for the same. That is blueprint for the development of money market in India. That's why these two committees are important. Do remember the names of these two committees. Today, money market in India is not an integrated unit and has two segments, that is unorganized money market and organized money market. So in India today, the money market is not an integrated unit. That is, organized money market and unorganized money market are not integrated together. It is two different units. One is unorganized, second one is organized. As we have already said, what is the difference between an organized money market and an unorganized money market? An organized money market is one which is regulated by the regulators. Unorganized is one which is not regulated by the regulators. So that is the difference. And these are the two money markets existing in India today. So that's it about money market. We'll be continuing with this module, financial market, in the next video. Thank you so much for watching. I wish you all the very best.